children. In the previous session we were discussing lines and angles, so we will continue with that. Before getting into the session, I want you all to maintain a 100 pages or 200 pages unruled book for both the maths and science. Take down the running notes as you go through the videos, as well as the notes that will be sent through app, and complete the assignments. Okay, and we will go to the problems that we were solving in the previous session on lines, linear pair LCM. So in the figure x plus y is equal to w plus z, prove that AOB is a line, is a straight line. Line is nothing but straight line, and these are the names of the angles x, y, z, w, x, y, z. So we will solve this with a given x plus y is equal to w plus z. These two, this is a condition which is given. Okay, we need to prove AOB is a straight line. To prove that AOB is a straight line, if we prove x plus y, which are the adjacent angles which sit on this AOB, if you prove that the sum of the angle x plus y is equal to 180 degrees, then we can say that AOB is a straight line. At point O, here you see the point O, x plus y plus y w plus z is equal to 360 degrees. We know that the angle around the point is 360 degrees. So the angle at point O is sum of all the angles x, w, x, y, z. So x plus y plus w plus z should be equal to 360 degrees. And we will group x plus y and w plus z. We know that x plus y is equal to w plus z. It's given in the question. So we will take this as x plus y as A. And w plus z also will become A. 360 degrees. A plus A will be 2A. 360 is equal to 360 degrees. A will be equal to 360 by 2, which is 180 degrees. Now we know what is A? X plus y. Therefore, x plus y is equal to 180 degrees. Hence, we can conclude AOB is a line. Which axiom? Converse of linear pair axiom. What does the converse of linear pair axiom say? Linear pair axiom, the converse of linear pair axiom says that the adjacent angles, the sum of the adjacent angles on a line is equal to 180 degrees. Then we can say that the line is a straight line. Now we will go to parallel lines and transversal. Before that, I will give you an assignment. Please copy that. Assignment for the previous concept, linear pair axiom. So please complete this assignment. And then we will move on to parallel lines and transversal. So in the previous class, that is in the 8th class itself, we have learned what is parallel lines and transversal. What happens when transversal intersect two parallel lines? Let's name it L, M, N. M and N are two parallel lines, and we indicate it here with arrows. And then you have another line L which intersects the two parallel lines. When this happens, when transversal intersect two parallel lines, we can see these angles form. One, two, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So what is the relationship between these angles? We have learned, we will just recall. What are angle 1 and 2? Angle 1 and 2. We can just name it as 1 and 2. 1 and 2 are linear pair. One and two, 3, 4, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8. Are these the only linear pairs? No. What about 1 and 8? 1 and 8, 2 and 7, 3 and 6, 4 and 5. What are these? They are all linear pair angles formed on the line, straight line. Now we will see other set of angles. What about the angle 1 and 3? 1 and 3 are corresponding angles. 1 and 3. What about 2 and 4? 2 and 4 are also corresponding pair. 8 and 6, similarly 8 and 6, 7 and 5. They are all corresponding. So corresponding angles are those angles which are formed on the same side of the transversal. Next we will see what is 1 and 5. Are they alternate angles and they are exterior, outside the parallel lines. Therefore 1 and 5 are exterior alternate angles. Similarly we have 8 and 4. Both are exterior alternate angles. When we have exterior alternate angles, we have interior also. 2 and 6, 7 and 3, they are alternate. They are on the either side of the transversal. Therefore, they are called as alternate. And since they are inside the parallel lines, they are called as interior alternate angles. Which are those? 2 and 6. 2 and 6. They are inside the parallel lines and on the either side of the transversal. Therefore, they are interior alternate. Which is the other pair? 3 and 7. These two pairs are interior alternate angles. What about 2 and 3? They are interior as well as they are on the same side of the transversal. 2 and 3. 2 and 3 are co-interior angles. 2 and 3. 7 and 6. These angles are not formed on the outside the parallel lines, so therefore there cannot be any exterior angles in this. There can be only it is inside the parallel lines. So both these pairs are called as co-interior angles. Now we have seen what type of angles are formed when a transversal intersect two parallel lines. Here we have corresponding angles axiom. We have seen linear pair axiom as axiom 1 and 2. Axiom 3 and 4 are corresponding angles axiom, which says when two lines are parallel and a transversal intersect them, there forms a corresponding pair, corresponding angles are formed and each pair will be equal. Here for example, L and M are two parallel lines and we have a transversal T which intersects them. We can see that angle 5 and angle 4, angle 6 and angle 2, each pair of corresponding angles will be equal. This is what the axiom 3 says. What does the axiom 4 say? That is corresponding angle axiom. It is a converse of 3. That is, if a transversal intersect two lines and each pair of corresponding angles are equal, then the two lines will be parallel to each other. So this is what is corresponding angles axiom. Based on this axiom, we have theorem 2 and 3, wherein we prove the alternate angles which are formed when a transversal intersect two parallel lines are equal. Okay, children, now you see that L and M are two parallel lines and T is a transversal. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of alternate interior angles, here what are the alternate interior angles? 1 and 2, 3 and 4 are alternate interior angles. We need to prove that 1 is equal to and angle 3 is equal to angle 4. So which are the pairs? 1 and 2, 3 and 4. We need to prove that they are alternate angles, alternate interior angles which are equal. So what we need to prove? 1 is equal to 2, angle 1 is equal to 2 and 3 is equal to 4. These are the pair of alternate interior angles. We will go to the proof. Consider angles 5 and 6. Angle 5 is equal to, for 1 and 2 we will first start with 6. Angle 6 is equal to angle 2. What type of angles are these? 6 and 2. We have learned the corresponding angles axiom 3 and 4. What does the axiom 3 say? When a transversal intersects two parallel lines, the corresponding angles are equal. Here the corresponding angles are 6 and 2. So we have 6 is equal to 2. Angle 6 is equal to angle 2. Why? Because of corresponding pair axiom. But 6 is also equal to angle 1. 6 is also equal to 1. What type of angles are they? They are vertically opposite angles. We will name this 1 and 2. So from equations 1 and 2, from equations 1 and 2, left hand side you see that it is angle 6 and right hand side 2 and 1. Since the left hand side angles are equal, we can equate 2 is equal to 1, which is what we need to prove. Similarly, to prove angle 3 is equal to angle 4, we will start with 5. 5 is equal to, angle 5 is equal to angle 4, which is corresponding angles. But 5 is also equal to angle 3, which are vertically opposite angles. Therefore, we can equate 4 is equal to 3. We can name it as 3 and 4. From 3 and 4, we have 4 is equal to 3. Hence, proven. This is what we need to prove. Angle 1 is equal to 2 and angle 3 is equal to 4, which are nothing but pair of interior angles, pair of alternate interior angles. Here we have theorem 4, which is a theorem 3, which is a converse of theorem 2. It says if a transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of alternate angles is equal, then two lines are parallel. It is a converse of our previous theorem. Therefore, we will prove that. What we need to prove? That the line L is parallel to M. What is given? Given is if a transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of alternate interior is equal. So the condition was already given 3 is equal to 4 and 2, 1 is equal to 2. For simplicity, I have not given the names of the angles as their variables. Here we have taken numbers for simplicity. In textbook, you can see AOB, AB as a line, and each angle will be named in 3 different variables. For simplicity, I have given numbers. So what is given? 3 is equal to 4 and 1 is equal to 2. These are pair of alternate angles. They are equal is what it says. If they are equal, then the two lines L and M are parallel to each other. We need to prove. We will start from 3. We know that angle 3 is equal to 4, but we also know that angle 3 is equal to angle 5. How? Because of vertically opposite angles. They are vertically opposite angles. Since 3 is equal to 4 and 3 is equal to 5, 3 is equal to 4 is given, we can conclude 5 is equal to 4. What is 5 is equal to 4? This is pair of corresponding angles. What is angle 5 and angle 4? They are pair of corresponding angles. If the pair of corresponding angles are equal, then if a transversal intersect two lines and a pair of corresponding angles are equal, we can say that those two lines are parallel from converse of corresponding angles axiom. And the axiom 3 says if the lines are parallel, the corresponding angles will be equal. Axiom 4 says the converse. Therefore, L is parallel to M because of converse of corresponding angles axiom. We have to mention this. Only then the theorem is complete. You have to mention the reason. Here ends the theorem. We have seen corresponding angles axiom and theorem. Theorems based on that. Now there are theorems 4 and 5 which says that co-interior angles, when a transversal intersect two parallel lines, co-interior angles are supplementary, or supplementary is nothing but 180 degree. The sum of the angles will be 180 degree. Co-interior angles are supplementary means the sum of the co-interior angles, 3 and 2, 3 plus 2 will be 180 degree, 1 plus 4 will be 180 degree. So we have theorem 4 and theorem 5 which talks about co-interior angles. And then we have theorem 6 which says lines which are parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. That is, if L is parallel to M, here in this condition L is parallel to M. If this line M is parallel to N, for example, there are three lines L, M and N, and you see a transversal T which intersects all these three lines. We know that L is parallel to M and M is parallel to N. The theorem says L will be parallel to N. L will be parallel to N. That is, these two lines are parallel to each other and this line L is parallel to N, then we say L is also parallel to N. This is what the theorem 6 says. Based on this, we will solve a problem. We will solve this problem in figure. If PQ is parallel to RS, angle MX, angle MXQ is 135 and MYR is 40, find angle X and Y. X and Y is this angle. To find this angle, we will do a small construction. Draw a parallel line through the point M through M. Draw AB parallel to PQ through M. So we have seen PQ, we know that it's given in the problem. PQ is parallel to RS. AB is parallel to PQ by construction. Therefore, AB is also parallel to RS by our theorem 6. AB is parallel to RS. Theorem 6. What does the theorem say? If a line is parallel to another line, then for example L and M, if L is parallel to M and M is parallel to N, we can say that L is parallel to N. To find out angle X and Y, we need to find out angle XMB and BMY. Angle XMB plus angle BMY is equal to angle XMY, the one which we need to find out. We have angle QXM plus angle XMB is equal to 180 degrees. Here, angle QXM is given as 135 degrees and XMB, these two angles, since PQ is parallel to AB, these two angles become co-interior angles and the sum of the co-interior angles will be 180 degrees because of co-interior angles. Therefore, angle XMB will be 180 minus what is given? 135, which is 45 degrees. Now, coming to this angle, MYR and BMY, these two angles here, therefore they will be equal. Angle BMY is equal to angle RMYB, BMY and MYR is equal to 40 degrees. Why? Because alternate interior angles. Therefore, we need angle X and Y. We can add angle XMB plus angle BMY, which is 45 plus 40. Which is 85 degrees. We'll go to the next problem. In the figure, AB is parallel to CD and CD is parallel to EF and Y is to Z. Here, the angle names are Y and Z. The ratio of these two angles are 3 and 7. We need to find out angle X. For this, there are many methods to find out this angle X. The easiest one would be, if angle Y is here, what about this angle? This is also Y. That is because of vertically opposite angles. And Y and Z are co-interior angles because CD is parallel to EF is given. Therefore, Y plus Z is equal to 180 degree. And using this ratio, we can find out angle Z. Once you find out angle Z, is angle Z equal to X? What type of angles are these? They are alternate interior angles, therefore they are equal. So once we find out Z, we can equate that to X. So angle, we can name it because there is no name given in the question. We can name this point O, DOP. because they are vertically opposite angles. And then we have y plus z. Y plus z is equal to 180 degrees. These two, because they are a pair of co-interior angles. Co-interior angles are supplementary. Y plus z is equal to 180 degrees. Now we will go to the ratio to find out the angle z, the value of the angle z. Y is to z is equal to 3 is to 7. Therefore, z will be, z is 7, right? 7 by, the total ratio will be 3 plus 7, 10 into y plus z is 180. So it is 126 degrees. Once z is 126 degrees, x is also equal to, this implies x is equal to z, which is equal to 126 degrees. What is the reason? Alternate interior angles.